Good afternoon. I lost my tripod, but I found it again. I'm going to put up two videos, because I've got something new, but I'd also thought I'd show you how to make a sling pot. Not a big deal, because I'm sure you can figure it out anyway, they're very simple, but I just thought, as an educational video, it's quite good. I use these. Purchased off eBay. They just over a pound for it, I think it was. Nice screw top lid, waterproof. As you can see here, I've got Bill in one, my Brachiopelma smithy. You can just see him or her there, with a little leg cup as a shelter. He absolutely loves it. It's a great little thing for her, him or her. And like I say, I'm going to show you how to make one similar. Not to say not that it's that difficult, because I've got a new one, I've got to convert one of these anyway. So, let's start with the process. I've just noticed I've got company here in this garage. There's a very unwell house spider. He's not doing very well, I don't think. And there's a garden orb keeping me company. Right, now, they've been thrown out. Right, just a second. Okay. Right. I have to go all the way back into work just to print one thing out. What I've got is very simple grid. I like the things to be as neat and tidy as possible, quite anal about things like that. So I printed out this grid system, and then what I'm gonna do is place this jar. Oops. Not really the best camera in the world for this, but what this will now do is sit around the edge like so, so I get a nice grid of holes, sort of right the way under the sub where the sub's going to go, and then all the way up to the top. And then for the top bit, got another grid which will go over the top there and do a nice grid pattern on the top of them. Now what I've got for that is, but I'm borrowing it, one of these. I want to call it a Dremel, but it's not a Dremel because those are really expensive. But they do have wonderful drill bits for making sort of precise size holes. Nothing too big, nothing too small. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to fix the my grid to the pot very technically with some sticky tape, just like Blue Peter. There we go. And so that one, like I say, hasn't exactly got to be perfect, but as long as it's on there flat. Another bit of tape, obviously you'll notice there's a gap there because the paper's not long enough, but I'll do that bit when I get there. But that's on there, nice and thing. Now we commence to drill. Power tools, cool. Sorry, power toolage, cool. Now, very simple process. Very delicately, turn it on, spinning away, just drill a hole in each of the that's that bit done. Now, what I do find is that particular tool, probably a Dremel, would probably be better at this, but you do tend to get on the inside, it's a little bit barbed. Now what I use to compensate for that is, sorry for looking at my groin, on that one, yeah, great, I can't find it. Maybe it's this one. Just to sort of tidy it up, I'm sure it's that one. It might be another one. Oops, to sort of tidy it up on the inside so that there's nothing that the tea can catch itself on. No, I'm sure it's that one. Like I say, very delicately, just go around the inside, because like I say, where these are here, you can see there, this is quite a protrusion. So you want to cut them off, and then what I'll also do is just put another set of holes down the middle of there, so there's a nice even set of ventilation all the way around. Well, I think that's done quite well. I'll do the lid as well in a second. Right, I'm just going to tidy this off. There we go, all done. I had to sort of just go over a few with my fingernail just to take off any sharp barbs or anything else, but that's much, oops, sorry, that's much better. I'll give it a rinse and wash before I go to put the tea in it. What I'm going to do now is, though, is put the do the lid. So what I need to do is, well, I haven't done it yet, cut out the grid and pop it in there and secure it. And I just need a piece of wood to drill on, and I'll film that because it'll be exciting. There we go. Secured very securely in there with green tape. And then what I'm going to do is just put, as you can see I've used this one before, put it on a piece of wood, oops, like so. So then that way, I won't go through to the worktop or anything. I need to drain the drill bit. Find the drill bit I was using, that's that one. So we're going to pop that one back in now, as opposed to the polisher I just was using. And very simply, just follow the grid. Here, which you can see there. And there we go. Again, a bit of a scrape of the old fingernails just to get the worst of it off. But you've got a perfectly good grid. Oh gosh, that actually has more than what it looks like. There we go. But a perfectly nice, neat grid ventilation holes. Take them out. Actually, if you save those, you can use them again, I found. I would have used them again, but somebody threw out the last ones I did. Again, just get rid of a few extra, there's a few extra sharp bits on the inside, but that's now all smooth. So there, we've got a perfectly nice lid, which can go on our perfectly nice pot. How lovely is that? And there you go, a simple sling enclosure with a nice secure lid so they can't get out. Holes are small enough so that they can't climb out, like happened to my green bottle blue the other day, which was scary. But yeah, it's a pretty good enclosure for a sling. Obviously you can sort of buy the pots whatever size you want. This one's a 10 centimeter one, by about 15 I think it is high, but that's a pretty good thing. Like I say, I'm going to give it a wash. Put that back out there so you can see me. I'm going to give that a wash, and then what I'm going to do is put some sub in there, put some bark in there, which I've got kicking around. There we go. Bits of, again, local Yumber yard, got it for free, for my new spider, which I shall hopefully put up in the next video. There might be a link here. God, technical. Hope you enjoyed that and you get some use out of it. If you've got any questions, please feel free to ask. Not that you need to, because it's pretty basic.